When it comes to obtaining greater Salesforce ROI, sandbox seeding is the one thing we all could be doing, but we're probably not, because it can be really hard. Before we go any further, let's make sure we're on the same page. What does sandbox seeding mean? Well, I'd propose this definition: the act of populating a Salesforce org with representative data so that it is usable for development. I'd also argue all Salesforce customers should be seeding. Yes, really. Even you. Now for the next minute and 30 seconds, I'll ask you to suspend everything you think you know about how Salesforce works, because we're about to change all of that. Your full copy or partial copy. Oh wait, you have both? Well, hey moneybags, those things are expensive. But just as if you were to leave your groceries out for too long, they start degrading the moment they're refreshed, because every day that passes, they get further away from production and less helpful to our testing. Meanwhile, your poor developer sandboxes and scratch orgs are waiting in the wings like Cinderella's ugly stepsisters, for sadly, no one wants to use them to develop their next project because they just don't have any real data in them. So time after time, we end up crammed into the same shared org, stomping on each other's work, and waiting for that faded refresh to be able to start our next big project. But this is Salesforce, and there's gotta be a better way. What if you could snap your fingers and give everyone on the team their own mini version of production? Then no one would have to worry about breaking things, and you could try that crazy idea that just might revolutionize how you do business. What if you could refresh every org in your release pipeline daily? You know what you're building is going to work exactly the same way in production. No more last-minute surprises. Your work will pass code coverage. Then you could work faster than you've ever imagined and achieve things that were previously considered impossible. That's the power of sandbox seeding. And it doesn't have to be a giant mess of CSVs, VLOOKUPs, mistakes, do-overs, and rage-inducing work. Not if you have Prodly app up sandbox seeding. Instead of wasting time hitting new over and over and over again, or praying to the data loader gods that I've sequenced my 20 CSV files in the exact right order, I'm going to use AppOps sandbox seeding. First things first, I'll add my newest sandbox to my environments page. Then I'll hop over to the seed sandbox wizard. I simply select my source, in this case production, and up to 5 destinations. Yep, you heard that right. I can seed up to 5 sandboxes and or scratch orgs all at the same time. Talk about a time saver after a major release, right? Next, I'll save myself even more time by using one of my datasets. Psst, Prodly provides these for free to all their customers. What's a dataset, you ask? Only the best thing ever. Let me show you. Datasets are pre-built templates that let me move an entire subsection of my org schema all at once, while maintaining all of my parent-child relationships and lookups. But what if I don't have a dataset? No problem. I can quickly select up to 25 related objects to seed on the fly. So if I'm working on a project and need about the last 6 months of opportunity data to test against, I just tell AppOps sandbox seeding that I want to start with the opportunity object, and that I'm also going to need contact roles, so therefore contacts too, and products. Oh, wait, there's not a direct relationship between opportunities and products. I'm going to need line items first. And let's grab accounts just to be safe. So here we have all 6 objects I'm going to deploy. Prodly will take care of how to sequence the objects for me automatically. Now to filter down to only the opportunity records I care about. The last 6 months, give or take, should be plenty. So I'll add a SOQL query where clause. Now behind the scenes, Prodly is going to save all of my selections as a new dataset in case I need to use it again. And I'll give this deployment a quick name so it's easy to find in my results. One last thing, like a lot of orgs, we have some data quality issues. Particularly, we're not always great about updating old records when we change a pick list value. So I'm going to ask Prodly to temporarily deactivate all of the platform automations in my destination environments to avoid Salesforce rejecting my record upserts. Since I'm just after an approximation of my production records, it's not actually important that my process builder processes, validation, workflow, and duplicate rules or triggers fire in my sandboxes. Now let's see what my data is doing in real time. AppOps sandbox seeding tracks my records as it moves them from environment to environment and is smart enough to know whether to do an update or an insert. No more duplicates for me. I can even drill down to the individual records in each environment to see exactly what is being moved, where, and how. I just moved 5,700 records in less than 12 and a half minutes. That's 9 separate CSV files that I did not need to remap. Best of all, my data was secure the entire time, and I didn't have to do a single export. With Prodly App Ops Sandbox seeding, my whole team can get started on Salesforce projects faster and experience less surprises along the way. It's like magic. Bippity, boppity, boom.